any discussion about public-private partnerships needs to be discussed and debated against the backdrop of what's happening to water globally and in Canada. One could argue if we had all the water we all thought we did once, maybe it wouldn't matter so much, but it's very important to look at this issue in terms of what's happening to water around the planet, because we are a planet running out of fresh water. Now, this was something we were all taught couldn't happen when we were back in grade six. You remember the story about the hydrologic cycle and the water goes round and round. What our teachers didn't know and didn't teach us is that we are polluting and diverting and mismanaging that water so badly that the United Nations now says, and this is astonishing, that by 2030, the demand for water in our world will outstrip supply by 40%. That means we will only have enough water for 60% of the demand in the world. And that means that the fight for water as a human right just got harder. It's going to be much more difficult to deliver on that UN resolution that some of us have been working on so hard when you're up against depleted groundwater, rivers and lakes that have been poisoned and dammed to death. And just the lack of water in many parts of the world. And trust me, it's astounding if you just take a tour around the world. 22 countries in Africa are in crisis. The entire Middle East is going to run out of water within the next 50 years. China, half the rivers in China have disappeared since 1990. Brazil, with tons of water, is in desperate drought in the south because they cut down the Amazon and all the rain that it gave off disappeared. The United States, the Ogallala Aquifer that goes down the back spine of the U.S. Midwest, will be gone in our lifetime, says the U.S. Department of Agriculture. So this notion that we have all the water to spare is not true. We are in crisis, and we need to understand that when we say, well, then who should be looking after water? How should water be managed? Now you say, aha, but we live in Canada, and Canada's different. We have 20% of the world's water. Hold on, no, we don't. We only have 20% of the world's water if we drain every river and lake. We have about 6.5% of the world's water, and most of that runs north in mighty rivers. We do not have water to spare. We have not taken care of our water. We have massive eutrophication, nutrient overload in 246 lakes across Canada, including Lake Winnipeg, including Lake Erie, very sick lakes. We allow poisons and herbicides and pesticides and chemicals to be used in our farming. We have no standards whatsoever for animal waste. We have no national drinking water standards. We have no protection for our groundwater. And the Harper government dismantled, gutted the only three decent water laws we had, the Fisheries Act, the Navigable Waters Protection Act, and the Canadian Environmental Assessment Act, which we're trying to get back now through consultations with the current government. So we really, you know, we like to think that we love our water and we have so much, what I call the myth of abundance. And, you know, it's in our myths and stories and so on. But actually, we take very poor care of our water, and it's time we stop doing that. Now, this is the backdrop that we have to use when we're saying, okay, should a water system be managed publicly or privately? What does it matter? Can it be either one? Well, it matters because there is a mighty contest happening around the world and here in Canada around this very question. Who is going to control water? Whoever controls water is going to be both powerful and arguably very wealthy. So you have a handful of powerful private utilities, Suez, Veolia, and a number of them, a number of private bottled water companies like Nestle, which is bottling billions and billions of liters, billions every year, taking it out of the ground. You have private food companies, private farm companies, private investors investing in water. So there is a struggle between whether water is going to be privatized for profit by big corporations, by international investment, by international capital, or whether it's going to stay in control of local governments and local communities. And that matters because if we don't control it locally, we are going to lose the ability to keep it clean, to preserve it, to have decisions around who gets to make, who gets access to it. Are you going to let all the water be fracked? Are you going to let all of it be bottled and sold internationally? If that's our water, don't we have a say? This is why the discussion around P3s matter, because once you start losing control, even if it's a small part of it, like the wastewater system or the pollution treatment system, you're still opening the door for profit in water. And water is a public trust. Water is a human right. Water is life itself. We absolutely cannot allow water to be privatized, private services to come along so that people have to pay more. And study after study around the world tell us that when P3s come into a water service, the service declines, the rates go up, and people are laid off. In fact, a study from the United States last year on the 500 biggest water services, municipal water services, including, you know, New York and Los Angeles and so on, found that the price, the water rate for drinking water was 59% higher in the P3 than the public managed, and for wastewater it was 63% higher. And one in three workers were laid off when water was privatized under a P3. Since the year 2000, 235 municipalities have gone back from trying privatization and said that was a mistake, gone back to a public system. Paris is one of the more recent ones. After a decade of private delivery, they were able to lower the rate of water to their customers within a year and build a nice sustainability fund. Because why? There's no profit. All the money that's being spent on water services is being spent on water services, not to pay investors. So please understand that this isn't a small little debate happening in a small community or a big community around something that's esoteric. This is life and death itself. We have to have a new water ethic where we say everything we do with water, the way we grow food, the way we produce energy, the way we trade across borders, has to protect water, and we have to keep it in the public realm. We owe this to the next generation who have the same right to breathe clean air and drink clean water that we do. Thank you so much.